When we look in the mirror, we see a person with all physical features. But are we really what we see in the mirror? Because we also have thoughts and emotions, but we cannot see or touch them. The question is, where does this intangible part come from? Does it come from what we see in the mirror? Or is the shape we see in the mirror actually the result of our invisible thoughts and emotions? And is the body that we see in the mirror really a solid dense mass? Many still believe that the material and mental worlds are separate. We have always been told that the world exists independently of us, and that the material world influences our thoughts. But can our thinking affect mental reality? Interestingly, science still has not proven that our consciousness is a product of our material brain. In other words, classical physics cannot fully explain the human mind. In addition, according to modern quantum theories of consciousness or quantum mind, our consciousness also behaves as a quantum particle. Namely, it can exist outside the brain in an immaterial form, while simultaneously existing inside the brain in a material form. Some scientists believe that quantum mechanics can help explain how we, humans, make decisions. So today we are going to dive into some aspects of the quantum world. But before we get started, make sure you're subscribed to this channel and hit the notification bell if you're interested in psychoeducational content from a mental health professional. Quantum physics is really mind-blowing because it is quite difficult to understand and counterintuitive, but at the same time, it is very exciting. I experienced it by myself when I delved into this subject. And the only way to understand the idea of quantum consciousness is to acquire at least a basic understanding of quantum physics. Quantum physics is a relatively new field of science that studies matter and energy at its most fundamental level. In other words, it's physics that explains how the world around us works. And although it began to develop in the middle of the 20th century, its use in everyday life has been studied since recently. The laws of quantum physics can be applied on a personal level, including the psychological. So, what is quantum psychology? It is simply the application of the logic of quantum physics to the field of psychology. In old school books, you can still find information that electrons rotate around the nucleus like the planets around the sun. But this is outdated information because, according to quantum physics, everything from the chair we sit on to the laptop we walk on to our bodies is made up of the tiny particles of vibrating energy, surrounded by a large empty space. It's the frequency at which these particles of energy vibrate determines what form energy will have. So the solidity, the materiality that we perceive is an illusion. And yet, when we touch with our almost empty hand, our almost empty table, we feel not empty space, but dense matter, right? So how is this possible? It has to do with energy fields. It is a fact that our universe is mostly empty space, but the energy fields that exist between the particles allow us to perceive what is mostly empty space as a solid object. These energy fields hold everything together and create the illusion of materiality. Almost everyone in the world believes that everything we see around us is material, solid and real. But everything is much more complicated, because particles surrounded by a huge empty space are not always solid. Something that may appear a certain way under one circumstance may react or appear differently under other circumstances. A good example is a scientific experiment with a substance called oobleck, or magic mud. It is a simple mixture of cornstarch and water. So this mixture is liquid, but until you apply force. If you slowly dip your fingers into it, it will look liquid and flow from your hands. And if you hit it hard with your fist, the surface of the liquid will withstand the impact, turning into an elastic mass. So when the oobleck is subjected to vibration and pressure, it becomes solid. But when you stop applying force, it will return to its liquid state. It's like magic. Humans are just as complex a system because we are no different from any other part of the universe. We are also made up from tiny vibrating particles of energy surrounded by vast empty spaces. And when we interact with other people or substances, there is an exchange of energy that affects everything that interacts with each other. We all leave traces of ourselves wherever we have been, and at the same time, we carry traces of everything we have been in contact with. In quantum physics, this exchange is called quantum entanglement. This means that if a pair of subatomic particles interact, they are permanently bound to each other. So everything that affects one of the particles will also affect the other. Time, distance, and space between them do not matter. Scientists still cannot explain exactly how such separated particles remain connected to each other. There is a theory that the consciousness of different people can intervene in a similar way. From the point of view of psychology, we can talk about collective consciousness. This may explain why you and your partner may have the same thought at the same time, because our bodies and minds are made up of these entangled particles that can receive and respond to information at the same moment. This hypothesis explains why our mood can be affected by a cheerful or grumpy person in the same room, even though we have not interacted with them directly. Because the stimulus can also take the form of energy, such as thought, prayer, emotion, and belief. But if we are all connected by quantum entanglement, why doesn't everything that happens affect us all? This can be explained by filtering. From a survival point of view, people became good at filtering to protect themselves from all the information that overloads them every second, so we can protect ourselves from the influence of other people's negative energy. If we learn to be aware of this process and equip ourselves with the right tools, we can make our lives happier. There is a concept in quantum physics called wave-particle duality. It means that every elementary particle, such as photon and electron, is either energy, which has the properties of a wave, or mass, which has the properties of a particle. So matter exists not only as matter, it also exists as energy. These two things exist in a state of so-called quantum superposition, in which they are neither a wave nor a particle, but only the possibility of both until they are either observed or measured. But at the moment of observation of measurement, the quantum superposition disappears, and then what once existed as a possibility of one or more states now exists in a single state, namely the wave or particle state. So if there were no observer, then the wave particle would exist infinitely in a state of pure possibility. A classic example demonstrating the phenomenon of quantum superposition is the double slit experiment. When scientists passed photons through the slits, They behaved like a wave and formed a pattern of light and dark stripes parallel to the slit as they hit the screen. But when the scientists wanted to record the moment the photon flew through the slit, two vertical stripes appeared on the screen. So a brick wall looks material and we feel it the same way when we touch it. And if we hit it with our fist, there will be bruises. But it is our interaction with the wall as an observer that brought it into solidity. This is the basis of our universe. It happens on a microscopic level with every single particle that makes up the matter of our solid universe. This also applies to things on a large scale. Researchers found that particles such as electrons are related to the observer, the physicist, the apparatus, and the method used for the observation. Scientists made assumption that the consciousness of the observer affects the physical events being observed, so mental phenomena affect the material world. Recent research supports the idea that the physical world is not the foundation or the only component of our reality. Moreover, it cannot be fully understood, ignoring the influence of mind and consciousness. What do you think? Share your thoughts in the comments. I will continue this topic in my next video. So don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video if you enjoyed it. Thank you for your attention. Bye.